Now in this video, I'm going to give some basic idea about Laplace transform. So sometimes we may get this use of Laplace transform in network theory, right, to solve some problem. And actually in signal system there is no Laplace transform concept, but in mathematics there is a Laplace transform. So sometimes in any way we may get at least one question from the Laplace transform, or we will get some use of Laplace transform in the GATE exam. So that's why we need to study the Laplace transform, right? So what I will do here is, so Laplace transform, what are the basics, what is the some properties we will see in this lecture. So unilateral Laplace transform will be there and bilateral Laplace transform is there, right? So unilateral transform is convenient when we solve differential equations with initial conditions. So remember this point, whenever there is some initial condition is given, so we have to use the unilateral transform. So bilateral transform is good for stability purpose or causality, so to find the system is causal or not, and what is the frequency response of that system, right? Now first we will see the bilateral transform. Very small difference between unilateral. So bilateral means we will get limits minus infinity to infinity, but unilateral means we will get 0 to infinity. Suppose x of s is equal to 0 to infinity x of t into e power minus st dt is the unilateral transform formula, and bilateral formula is some h of s is equal to, or x of s is equal to h of tau e power minus s tau into d tau. So remember this h of s, suppose input is exponential function, so to find the y of t, so this will become y of t is equal to x h of s into e power st, right? So sometimes we may get questions from this, if input is x e power st, what is the eigen function of a given equation or etc. So we know that a signal for which the system output is a constant times the input is referred to as an eigen function, that is e power st. And the amplitude factor is referred to as the system eigenvalue. So e power st is the eigen function and h of s is the constant value or eigenvalue. So h of s is the Laplace transform of the impulse transform ht. So if h of s is equal to 0 to infinity, so h of t e power 1 st, it will become unilateral, right? Remember, whenever the input is exponential, so y of t is equal to some h of s into e power st. E power st is called eigen function, and this is called eigen value. So remember this. So from that only we get the Laplace transform of given x of t is x of s is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus st into dt. Now how to find inverse Laplace transform? So generally this equation is not required when we find the inverse Laplace transform, that we'll see later. But what is the inverse Laplace transform is, here s is equal to sigma plus j omega. So real part will be there and imaginary part will be there. So h of sigma plus j omega is equal to, Laplace transform is h of t into e power minus sigma t. So actually e power minus st, so e power minus x plus j omega t. So if I see, this is the Fourier transform of this signal, total overall signal, right? So that's why h of t will become 1 by 2 pi j into integration of sigma minus j infinity to sigma plus j infinity into h of s into e power st into ds. This is to find the inverse Laplace transform. Anyway, we don't use this expression. We will find directly by looking the transfer function or etc. So h of t is 1 by 2 pi j sigma minus j infinity to sigma plus j infinity h of s into e power st into ds. So remember this one. Now relation between Fourier transform and Laplace transform. So Laplace transform x of t is equal to x of s into e power minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus st into dt, right? So x of s is equal to, like this, Laplace transform x of t is equal to Fourier transform x of t into e power minus sigma t, because s is minus sigma plus j omega t. So we know that Fourier transform x of j omega is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt. So in place of x of t, here I will get x of t into e power minus sigma t. So that is the, now if sigma is equal to 0, so Laplace transform is equal to Fourier transform. That's why we have to see that whenever real part of any signal is, in a Laplace transform is 0, so it will have some Fourier transform also. So that is the case. Now we see the region of convergence. So we cannot find the Laplace transform for all signals, right? So that is why we have to go for the region of convergence. So Laplace transform x of t is equal to Fourier transform f of x of t into e power minus sigma t. Whenever this is absolutely integrable, then only we will have convergence or Fourier transform will be there, or we can say Laplace transform is there. Laplace transform is guaranteed to converge if x of t into e power minus sigma t is absolutely integrable, right? So that is this. So this is the convergence of the Fourier transform, or we can say Laplace transform also. So for that reason we will get the region of convergence. The range of RS or region of convergence is equal to sigma, for which the Laplace transform convergence is referred as the ROC. So always real of S is either greater than 0 or less than 0 or greater than A or less than A. That is the convergence generally we take, right? Now one more very good point is, if ROC includes j omega axis, x of t is Fourier transformable. That means for x of t the Fourier transform also exists, then x of omega can be obtained by putting s is equal to j omega if ROC includes, right? Now whenever we go for S plane, it will have real part as well as imaginary part. Then it will have left half S plane and right half S plane, right? So always the transfer function will have poles and zeros. So m zeros and n poles, it can be represented by n of s by d of s, something like this, right? So this is some basic about the Laplace transform. Now we will find the Laplace transform basic. Suppose x of t is equal to e power minus a t into u of t. So it will become like this. So which is integrable. So x of s exists. Actually it should be minus infinity to infinity. Because of u of t, it will be limits 0 to infinity. Whenever 0 to infinity e power minus a t into e power minus s t, if I take minus common, it will become s plus a into t into dt. Now we know integration of e power x dx is equal to e power x. So I am assuming x. So I have to do the again differentiation to the x. So in respect to differentiation of t, I will get minus of s plus a. Now if I substitute infinity here, so e power minus infinity is 0, assuming that s plus a should be greater than 0. This is the region of convergence we will get generally. Suppose if s plus a is less than 0, this term will get e power infinity. So e power infinity means infinity only, which is not convergible. So that's why real of s or s plus a is greater than 0, or real of s is greater than minus a. So what is this? E power minus infinity will become 0. When I substitute 0, I will get 1 by s plus a. So 0 minus of minus 1 by s plus a. So I will get 1 by s plus a. So remember, we can directly remember if e power minus a t u t is there. So directly it is a Fourier transform, or Laplace transform is 1 by s plus a, and the region of convergence is real of s is greater than minus a. Remember, now if I take minus of e power minus a t into u of minus t, so what I will get here is this is the signal we should get, right, which is a easily convergible. So there is a Fourier transform will exist, minus of minus infinity to 0, because it's a u of minus t. So e power minus a t into e power minus s t into dt. So if I substitute here e power x again, so e power x by differentiation of again x here, so I will get 1 by s plus a. Real of s should be less than minus a here. Reason is, whenever this is s plus a is less than 0, I will get e power s plus a into t, positive, but here limit is minus, so again we will get minus infinity. So e power minus infinity will become 0, then we will get the Laplace form is like this. So the moment we see minus of e power minus a t u of minus t, so again Fourier transform is, Laplace transform is same, but region of convergence will become different. That is, our real of s is less than minus a. So whenever x of, in place of x of minus t, if I place only u of minus t, so which is minus infinity to 0, we will get the region of convergence is opposite of this one. So here real of s is greater than minus a, here real of s is less than minus a. This is how to do the Laplace transform. So now there is some properties of ROC. ROC of x of s consists of strips, that is, there is a parallel strips either greater than minus a, suppose it is a, or less than minus a, etc., right? If x of is rational, then ROC must contain any poles. So there is one more point. If x of is finite duration and is absolutely integrable, then ROC is the entire exponent. Remember, u of t is not a finite value. Suppose there is a finite minus 1 to 1 x of t, then it will have the ROC is simply entire exponent. Right? If x of t is right sided and infinite duration, then the ROC is right to the right of the rightmost pole. Right? If x of t is right sided, that is like this. If x of t is left sided, the ROC is the leftmost of the left of the S-plane. Remember this also. If x of t is two sided and infinite duration, so it may be two sided, the x of t will be there, then ROC will consist of a strip in the S-plane. So something like this. So this is for two sided x of t. It is like this, e power minus 2t into u of t minus of e power minus 3t into u of t. We know that this is for re is greater than minus 2. This is also re is greater than minus 3. So we will get 1 by s plus 2 minus 1 by s plus 3. So minus 2 minus 3. So we will get two actually regions, but what is the common region is real of s is greater than minus 2. This is how. Similarly, so many problems we will do. So we it can be, see, the moment u of minus t comes, r of s is less than minus 3. Here also u of minus t less than minus 2 we will get, right? Remember these points. So next, in the next lecture we'll see some more problems, then we'll see the properties also.